Baruch the Yehovah, Baruch the Yahweh Shai, Baruch the Yehovah, Baruch the Yahweh Shai, Baruch the Yehovah, Baruch the Yahweh Shai, Baruch the Yehovah, Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim Bracha HaKodash. Double honor to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, and shalom to the hopeful elect, brothers and sisters who believe in this truth. All right, and this is Brother Daniela coming back again at GMS Pittsburgh, doing another lesson through the Spirit and Power of Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. And basically, this is based off of something that the elder bro sent in the chat on how, you know, different religious groups are being persecuted and thrown into prison, all right, in these other countries, right? Specifically, Muslims and Jehovah Witness groups being thrown, all right, in a prison in Russia, in China, Singapore, different places around the world. And this is a, you know, this is like a precursor to what they're going to do with us, man. Us who are preaching in the names of Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, and preaching the true doctrine, the true teaching of the scriptures, who are in this truth, man. Right? Now, they're doing this to people who don't believe in the truth, man. All right? You know, well, Jehovah's Witnesses, they have, you know, they have they don't really know the scriptures, right? But anything that falls under a apocalyptic belief, all right, that's against the society, they're going to throw them in the jail. All right? And, you know, put them in re-education camps. And this is all according to prophecy, man. You know, really, this is going to happen for those who fear the Lord, man. All right. But let me read some of these articles here. This article is from ABC News. All right. Entitled Russian Jehovah Witness sentenced to 7.5 years in prison. All right. The Jehovah's Witnesses say that a member of the religious denomination that is banned in Russia has been sentenced to 7.5 years in prison. So being a Jehovah's Witness in Russia is banned. Right. It's outlawed. OK, you're not allowed to practice that religion in Russia. So this man has been sentenced to 7.5 years in prison for practicing that. Talk about draconian, right? The harshest punishments in scores of cat cases, all right? Right, it says the denomination's European office said 63-year-old Alexander Ivashin was sentenced on Wednesday in the Krasnodar region of southern Russia. Right, it says authorities said that he conducted religious discussions with friends in another city by video link. Russian banned Jehovah's Witnesses in 2017 and declared the religious group and extremist organization, right? So, since they were declared an extremist organization, you know, they banned them, and now they're undergoing harsh punishments, man. Right, and over here in America, they're demonizing us and are going to declare us as, well, they already have, is written in their plans to be extremist groups. All right, even though, you know, I'll speak for Great Millstone in particular. You know, we're a non-violent group, man. You know, we don't go picking up arms and doing this and doing that, right? Because the scripture says what? Leave a place for wrath, all right? All right, for vengeance is the Lord's, you know? So we don't rise up to try to avenge ourselves. Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai is going to do that for us. It says currently 46 members are imprisoned and 27 are 27 under house arrest, the denomination says, man. So that's in Russia, man. This is going on in Russia. Okay, they were rounded up and thrown into prison. All right, and some of them on house arrest and punished harshly, man. You know, this type of thing is coming to America, man. All right? That's one thing that in the past couple of years that you can notice. The things that are happening in other countries, the anarchy, the sedition, or the insurrection, okay, the persecution in all these other countries is seeping its way into America. And that's all according to prophecy. All right, this is another article from BBC.com, which is BBC.com, News World, Asia, China, Slovakia. And Lord will, I'm going to put these, links in the description. It says, data leak reveals how China brainwashes Uyghurs in a prison camp in Slovakia. Let's look up Uyghurs real quick. That's a sect of Muslims. Let's look it up real quick. Russia. Right, so it says Uyghurs ethnic group. It says Uyghurs are alternatively spelled whatever the alternative spelling is, are a Turkic ethnic group originating from the culturally affiliated with the general region of Central and East Asia. The Uyghurs are recognized as native to Xinjiang, Uyghur Autonomous Region in northwest China. All right. Let's see here. Total population 13.5 million. Languages, related ethnic group. Slovakia. Right. So it says here, basically, they follow that religion of Islam. It says Islam in China. Islam has been practiced in China for about 1400 years. Muslims are a minority group in China, representing between 0.45% to 2.85% of the total population, according to the local government. Other independent sources claim between 60 and 80 million Muslims in China. Wow. Right, so basically these Uyghurs practice the religion of Islam, for what I'm seeing here. But let's read this article, read some more. Okay, it says data leak reveals how China brainwashes Uyghurs in prison camps, right? Keyword, prison camps, right? And it says, leaked documents detail for the first time China's systematic brainwashing of hundreds of thousands of Muslims in a network of high security prison camps. Look at that. Does that sound familiar? You know, people's plans for re-education camps here in America. Right? This is what's going on. It says the Chinese government is consistently claimed the camps in the far western Xinjiang region offer voluntary education and training. So this is what they're supposing. This is what they're putting forth. All right, they're lying and saying that, oh no, they're voluntarily getting education and training. They're doing this voluntarily, you know. It says, but official documents seen by BBC Panorama show how inmates are locked up, indoctrinated, and punished, man. So this is done by force. China's UK ambassador dismissed the documents as fake news. The leak was made to the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists, which has worked with 17 media partners, including BBC, Panorama, BBC Panorama, The Guardian newspaper in UK. The investigation has found new evidence which undermines Beijing's claim that the detention camps, which have been built across Xinjiang's in the past 3 years, are for voluntary re-education purposes to counter extremism. About a million people, mostly from Muslim Uyghur community, are thought to have been detained without trial. I spent 7 days of hell in Chinese camps. This is another article they have here, and also a quote from one of those people who are experiencing that. Leading Uyghur geographer who vanished in China. Right, so they're snatching these people up and throwing them in concentration camps, re-education camps, man. Okay, where they brainwash people, okay, basically out of their religion to conform to whatever they want them to believe. All right, so Slovakia. You know, that being said, let's get some scriptures, because this is happening around the world, but this is going to come to America. All right. And this is really going to come hard on the people of the Lord. Okay. Those who say that they believe in this Hebrew Israelite thing. All right. Who proclaim themselves to be an Israelite and teaching the Bible. All of us are going to get tried, man. All right. This is going to be the hour of temptation, man. This is we're going to start here in Revelation chapter 2. This is Revelation chapter 2 and verse 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried. And ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give you a crown of life. Right, so the devil, all right, which is not talking about the spiritual demon Satan. All right, it's talking about, you know, Esau, Edom, okay, the red man, the beast man, all right, who controls everything in the world, all right, the so-called Caucasian, all right, it's talking about him. He's going to cast us into prison, all right, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days, so, you know, it's going to be a tribulation, man. Trials within a certain period of time. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give you a crown of life, man. So for those men who are faithful unto death, all right, if we're faithful unto death, the Lord will crown us who are, you know, believing in this truth with life, man, eternal life. All right. But, you know, the point is, he's going to cast people into prison. Now, he's not going to get everybody, right? Because the standard is going to be lifted up against this devil. But some of us will be cast into prison, all right, and be martyrs for Yahweh, for the testimony of Yahweh Shai. All right. This is Matthew chapter 24 and verse 9. It says, then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, right? We're going to be afflicted, all right, and persecuted by this devil, man, and shall kill you, right? Certain brothers are going to be martyrs, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. So everybody's going to hate us, and you can see it already. They already hate us, all right? And the most hated camp is Great Millstone, all right? So we must be doing something right, huh? we're doing something right because we're hated of everybody, man. It says, and another shall, Salakia. And you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. For the sake of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, we're going to be hated. And we are hated. All right? But that hate is going to manifest into action. All right? It says, right, that's the point I wanted from there. Now, let me get this. This is, right, now, we're hated, you know, by these other people because we're against this NWO, this satanic system, man. So, of course, people are going to persecute us because we're not with them, man. Okay, we're not in league with them. Okay, we're against them, man. This is Isaiah chapter 59, verse 15. Yea, truth faileth, and he that departeth from evil maketh himself a prey. So us that came out of this world in this satanic system, all right, and departed from evil and wickedness, all right, and who are laying hold, okay, unto righteousness and serving Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai with everything we got, okay, that, you know, we make ourselves a prey unto these other people, man. You know, if you're not with these people in their wickedness, right, they view you as a threat, all right, so they prey on you, man, all right, and that's what's coming down the pipe, man. You know, serious times is coming down the pipe. It says, and the Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no judgment, man. Right, man. So, hey, we're going to be persecuted for all these different things, man. And we are persecuted. All right, they demonize us on the media, man. You know that his mouth frameth a deceit, man. So they're gonna demonize us, okay, and make us out to be terrorists, okay, which we're not, you know, just to justify them in persecuting us, okay, and destroying us, man. It says this is 2 Ezra chapter 16 and verse 68. For behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you, and they shall take away certain of you and feed you being idle with things often offered unto idols, man. So that burning wrath is going to be E and his military. All right, coming down, okay, to persecute the men of the Lord. All right, and the elect, anybody who believes, all right, you know, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai in the scriptures, man, professing themselves to be Israelites. All right, it says, and they that consent unto them shall be had in derision and in reproach and trodden underfoot. So those who consent unto this devil, you're gonna be laughed at, man. Okay, and had in derision. Okay, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is gonna laugh at you through his men. That's why Proverbs 1 says what? I will laugh at your calamity, man. Right? You want to try? You don't want to because you didn't hear the reproof and the instruction of wisdom from Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, okay, through his men. So you're gonna be laughed at when your fear cometh and your calamity comes. All right. It says, "For there shall be in every place." And in the next cities, a great insurrection. And the insurrection is an uprising, man. And a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord, man. So us that believe in this truth and fear Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, we're going to be persecuted. Okay? There's going to be an insurrection. Military troops coming up against us. Androids, man. Robots. Whatever weapon this devil got, they're going to be coming up against us, man. All right. But us who are dwelling in this truth, man, the Lord has protection for us, man. All right? He's going to raise up a standard for us so long as we continue in his faith unto the end. It says, they shall be like mad men, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. They shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses, man. So we're going to be casted out of our houses. They're going to take away everything we got, our cars, possessions, whatever, man. Some of us are even going to have to, flee, man, and say, forget about all these possessions, man. Forget about your car, your nice clothes, and your nice house. We're gonna have to leave that, man. As the scriptures say, when you read up in this chapter, you know, be ye even as pilgrims upon the earth. In those evil days, man. It says they shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. Salakia. I believe did I read that already? Right. So this devil's gonna be like a madman. Okay, he's not gonna spare none. Okay, he's gonna be out for blood. He's bloodthirsty, man. Alright? He's already drunken with the blood of the saints. Okay, he's already killed so many of our people. Okay. So this is nothing to this devil, man. It says, for they shall, right, I just read that, for they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Then shall they be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as gold in a furnace, man. So this is not going to be an easy road, all right, unto getting into the kingdom. The righteous shall scarcely be saved, as the scriptures say. Right, but it's going to be made known because the Lord is going to lift up a standard for these people, man. All right, this is going to be a time of trouble such as never before since there was a nation, as it says in Daniel the 12th chapter, so much that Michael the archangel is going to have to come and help us, man. That's how bad this is going to get. All right, and that's why we're hoping and praying that the Lord keep us within this truth unto the end, you know. And I'm just, you know, doing a spiritual report on this because these times are coming, man. All right. And now is more than time than ever to try to stay locked in, all right, into the spirit and you know, to try and please Yahweh Hashem Yahusha to the best of our ability. You know, so with that, once again, all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Hashem Yahusha, Hashem Rakakwadash. Double honor to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, and shalom to the hopeful elect. Shalom.